Hello students, I'm JP Nautia, teaching you computer application, class 10, chapter 1, unit 1, and this is the 8th part of the video in which we will discuss about the terms of a website. Now protocols, a protocol is a system of rules that defines how something is to be done. That is protocol, that how any work can be done, some rules and regulations, that's called protocol. In computer terminology, a protocol is usually an agreed upon or standardized method for transmitting data and or stabilizing communications between different devices. In the following lines, we are discussing the most common protocols of World Wide Web, which are Hypertext Transfer Protocol and Hypertext Transfer Protocol Secure Protocol. That is, so Hypertext Transfer Protocol refers to a special format of text that contains links to the other texts, just the way we find links on a web page which lead to other pages. To create such pages, hypertext files are created. The Hypertext Transfer Protocol is an accessed method to access the web page, that is called accessed method used on internet. It is the primary access method for interacting with internet. The Hypertext Transfer Protocol HTTP generally works in combination with www. The HTTP is responsible for accessing hypertext document on World Wide Web. Since World Wide Web is a system governing the use of multimedia files on the net, and hypertext file support multimedia, the HTTP Hypertext Transfer Protocol generally works in combination of www. When the first part of URL denotes HTTP, example http://www.w3schools.com. So here's the note. Now Hypertext Transfer Protocol is a set of rules for transferring hypertext, it is the text, graphics, image, sound, video, etc. on World Wide Web. So the above URL indicates that the local software on your machine to expect a Hypertext Transfer Protocol file. Now HTTP, this is S stands for secure, Hypertext Transfer Protocol secure. HTTPS is another text exchange protocol that has full form as Hypertext Transfer Protocol secure. In other words, HTTPS protocol ensures the security of the text or information being transferred over World Wide Web. Now with regular HTTP protocol, the text information being transferred flow from server to browser directly without any encryption, which means it can be easily stolen. You can understand encryption as this. What's encryption? The actual text or information is converted into some code words using a specific type of technology called SSL, Secured Socket Layer Certificate. So the SSL socket layer certificate helps to create a secured and encrypted connection between the server and browser. This ensures that the information is encryption and connection is safe, so that hackers cannot steal your crucial or sensitive information such as login ID, password for online payment, etc., etc. So as a note, HTTPS Hypertext Transfer Protocol is enhanced version of HTTP working with SSL, Secured Socket Layer Certificate. SSL takes care of ensuring that the data goes securely over the internet. Now here's a note, both HTTP and HTTPS protocols are used to transfer hypertext documents on the World Wide Web. HTTPS is used for sensitive information shared over internet, such as financial data or information, personal details or bank details, login ID, password, etc. Now here's again, this is the chapter 1, unit 1, internet basics, and following figures explain the difference between the HTTP and HTTPS protocol. See, now this is the client computer, like our computer, and this is the server CPU, server computer. So Here HTTP if working in between. So this is unsecured connection link between server and browser client. So here's the client, and if HTTPS governing in between, that is secure connection link in between. So that is one extra layer and which is protected. So this is how to check if the connection is secure or not secure. So before keying any personal or financial information on any website, make sure that the URL of the website starts with HTTPS and there is padlock sign. This sign must be there and HTTPS should be there. And on the navigation bar, the footer of your browser shows like this. The footer of the browser shows like footer of the, this is not the footer, this is the header of the browser. So it is a mistake. So this is the header of the browser, look like this. This is the top one, the address bar. So this is, so following table, this is the table which ensures that HTTP and HTTPS. Number one, HTTP, it is a system for transferring information over the internet without any security feature. And HTTPS, this is a system of transferring information with SSL, secured socket layer, that encrypts and sends information over a secure connection, making it hard to steal. Now HTTP is useful for sending non-sensitive information, and HTTPS is useful for transferring exchange sensitive information. HTTP is generally used for blogs, entertainment information and general articles, etc. But HTTPS is used for exchanging information such as login details, bank details, payment details, etc. Now hypertext transfer protocol is not require any additional technology for data exchange or transfer, but HTTPS requires additional SSL layer, secure socket layer, certificate, a secure exchange of data information through the network connection. Now these are the revision topics. Let us revise once again the entire chapter. Internet is a network of many small networks that exists all over the world. Second, the World Wide Web is a set of programs, standards and protocols that allows the multimedia files to be created, displayed and linked on the internet. Third thing, the hypertext is combination of text, graphics, images, audio and video tracks, audio video tracks and hyperlinks. A server is a computer that has server software loaded on it. Its main job is to share resources for clients. A web server is a specific protocol type of server looking only for HTTP requests instead of many different type of resources or requests. Now there can be many type of server associated with network. It is that login server, proxy servers, web servers, mail servers, application server, real-time communication server, file transfer protocol server, print server, telnet server, database server, DNS server, etc. A website or a site is a group of related web pages hosted on a web server and are linked together and share a common interface and design. And a web portal is also a type of website, but it differs content and the services from a typical website that provide only specialized information. So you can pause and you can read it again. So here there are the questions, assignment based questions. This question answer to be noted down in your notebook. So you can take pauses. I am fast forwarding here, but you can take pause in between the video, and the text is visualizing very neatly, very cleanly. So I am scrolling once the entire practices. So these are the question answers, these keywords to be learned, and these are other theoretical questions to be solved from the chapter. And that's all of the chapter. Hope you enjoyed. Thank you.